The Battle of the Mind. Being human, we all experience fear, whether it is a healthy fear or an unhealthy fear. People sometimes love the adrenaline rush, like skydiving, bungee jumping, roller coaster, etc. People are prepared to risk death for the love of fear. Above is the fear that people enjoy, and there is a fear that torments us. Are we fearful for our lives? Everything you hold dear to you is going to be torn from your hands by death. Whether we like it or not, we are all part of the ultimate statistic, 10 out of 10 die. What is the essence of fear that torments us? There is a fear of not being loved, a fear of rejection, a fear of looking foolish, a fear of being alone, a fear of being forgotten, a fear of losing loved ones, a fear of death, etc. And fear not them which kill the body, but are not able to kill the soul, but rather fear him which is able to destroy both soul and body in hell. Matthew 10:28. There is a fear that God doesn't send. We are all fighting a spiritual battle in our minds. Please read Ephesians 6:10-17. Fear comes without permission. Fear can paralyze us, steal our joy, can cause anxiety, negative thinking, and depression when we dwell on it. There is a great beast called fear seeking to overcome us, and if we don't overcome it, it will consume us. We have the option of either casting down those negative, fearful thoughts or dwelling on them. The good news is negative thoughts can be replaced with positive ones. For God hath not given us a spirit of fear, but of power and of love and of a sound mind. 2 Timothy 1:7. The Bible says, the fear of man is a snare unto you. The fear of man bringeth a snare, but whoso putteth his trust in the Lord shall be safe. Proverbs 29:25. If you were to stand on a cliff, put your toes over the edge, with rocks at the bottom, all the stones crumbling beneath your feet, would that be scary? It would be a horrifying feeling. Would that feeling of fear be a good feeling or a bad feeling? Most people would say it's a bad feeling. That bad feeling is saying back off from the cliff edge. That fear is saving your life. That fear is your friend, not your enemy. The Bible says, through the fear of the Lord men depart from evil. By mercy and truth iniquity is purged, and by the fear of the Lord men depart from evil. Proverbs 16:6. Surrender the fear that you feel into God's hands and conquer that fear through prayer and by replacing those negative fearful thoughts by meditating on the Word of God. Casting down imaginations and every high thing that exalteth itself against the knowledge of God, and bringing into captivity every thought to the obedience of Christ. 2 Corinthians 10:5. Be careful for nothing, but in everything by prayer and supplication with thanksgiving let your requests be made known unto God. And the peace of God which passeth all understanding shall keep your hearts and minds through Christ Jesus. Philippians 4:6-7. The fear of the Lord is a healthy fear. When sinners repent and believe the gospel of Jesus Christ, the eyes of their understanding are enlightened. The fear of the Lord is the beginning of wisdom, and the knowledge of the holy is understanding. Proverbs 9:10. Blessings in Christ. David and Gay, please visit our website, OneWayToGrace.com. Thank you.